Welcome everyone, it's Vapors of Dracomar. It's time for some more Raid Shadow Legends. Yes, sirree. So, first things first, got to improve my Valerie. And my armorer. I think I'm gonna take him to the other stage, but I wanna give this a roll for some Valerie. I'm just testing his damage. His damage isn't really the big problem. It's the fact that he has to live long enough to make it to the end. That's the problem. I guess if I force fed him XP, that would do it. The main problem is he strips buffs. The Frostbiter. That's his main issue. So, I want to see if Valerie's the answer to helping that. I'm going to put a shield on everyone so that they'll have trouble stripping the buffs? Question mark. Is that the answer? Okay, yeah, he's striking him. The main thing is, I have to somehow keep Armor Girl alive. That's the real issue. And the problem is, the Frost Spider strips the buffs. So, I've got to find a way to fix that. I might need another champion to do it. Okay, I want to make sure that I bought the fragment later. I'm still looking for... still looking for the thing. Imagine what he would be like with the Long Master. That would be pretty dope, wouldn't it? Okay, yeah, now that's the Armiger I really know. That, right there. Did anyone see that damage? Yeah. So basically from here on out, we're gonna wanna solo pump XP in there. Because my main objective right here is to try to get him to 50 at least, so at least I feel a little better about it. And Because, yeah, he needs to have... He needs to have some very Omega XP. Because otherwise a spider will just kick his butt. And then I have to look up strategies. I mean, I have a theory that would work, but it involves upgrading Valerie. And to upgrade Valerie in general, I'm gonna have to farm some food. Right now, though, I'm just trying to pump her up to 50. I may have to pump her to 60. Perfect. That's what I want to see. Because that's what he's for. That's his, like, big purpose in life besides turn meter decrease, is to block revive. If he doesn't block revive, then he's not doing his job. Let's do 10. It's about as much as I can tolerate anyway. I can enjoy him smacking me. How much he crits. He doesn't crit as much as he needs to, I don't think, but again, his gear isn't the best. I'm doing this for a reason, because I'm trying to just, like, pump the XP in him. Get him that infusion. Trying to infuse him with that XP. I mean, he's doing some smacks. Is just keeping him alive is gonna be a nightmare. Trying to use up some of my multi-battles. This would have been better when I had more energy. I prefer manual, as you probably all already know. Basically what I'm trying, yeah, so as you can see, I'm trying to pump some XP in him with this demons. To try to get him to that godlike state that I need him to. This is a prelude to the trouble I have to go through. Because then I have to upgrade him and then I have to look into strategies. because now they're gonna like keep them at this level for a while. Because you would think he would go over level, but the fact of the matter is, even with him having all this XP pulsing through his veins, he's still gonna take a while before he actually puts the XP in. He always goes for the block revive the second they're low. He doesn't even bother to increase the 10 meter. One thing I've noticed about the auto emitter. He uses the, he always uses that move first. More multi battles before he reaches level 50. He is going to be my first ever rank 6 Sacred Order. And there's a reason for it. His reason. The reason that he's in my first is that he has all these valuable abilities. Try to boost his XP. He hasn't even reached his full form yet. Because his full form, he's gonna need with the level 10. The next thing I have to do is try to boost this guy's gear. Which, as you can probably imagine, is a very difficult thing to do. Because that's my problem. I am going to have to grind for silver. But yeah. Let's just not do auto. Okay, so we got him to 50, and we tried to mess with his gear some. I still think it's going to have to be a while. Before he gets to where he needs to be. The reason I'm even bothering to do all this is I'm trying to give myself this execution. It's hard to get him the levels to make him truly stand out. If you give him just one more level, I think we can do it. He's good in arena if you need somebody to kill the, if you need someone to block revive. What he's good for. That's about all you want for that. I'm gonna be... First, I'm gonna try it with... Trying to go with three of my strongest 60s. I'm putting her as a sideliner for a shield. Because I'm thinking that maybe putting a shield will benefit us. Because I've seen people put 40s in here before and have it work out. Why him? Why not the Valerie? Gotta get used to the way it works in this boss. This boss is very dangerous. So it has a persistence passive. I just murdered Alhane. What? Wow. So it's even decreasing the thing's turn music. But it has a persistence passive. The fight's over anyway. We're not beating it without an execute. It's not happening. We'll do this later. I can't do it. It just... I don't know what to do. Like, that sucker... I have to look up what to do, because I don't understand that boss very well. I mean, I could have beat this if I invested, but I decided to go the I try to kill Frostbiter route and look like a fool. I went that route. Let's do a Minotaur, shall we? Might as well give Hikatuner scrolls. She's earned it anyway. Wow, does anyone see how much that rookie shot damage did? Yuck. Yuck. It's not necessary to take Haichatune to 60 in life. You'll want that and more. You'll want that plus good gear. Because it'll take a while. It'll be easier to take her to 60 than it is to get the gear that you need. And even when you do, you'll want the 60 and the gear. You'll want both. To get Armiger to 60 at some point. There's just no way out. There seems to be no way out other than that, which we'll have to do later. We literally have to get Armiger to 60. And then even then, I still have to figure out a strategy. Maybe I have to upgrade Valerie, or if Valerie could like shield off the remove buffs. Yes. I gotta think out the protection. Cause I need to look back. Chip away at that Minotaur. I swear, those hexes take their toll. They really do. Gotta keep attacking that Minotaur. In the end, I'm just gonna attack the Minotaur. I'm not gonna bother killing his cronies. Because I think that's the fastest way to get rid of him. Because these cronies have so much health that there's just no point. It's not like they're stacking any more hexes anyway. That's purely the Minotaur. Virgus can last longer than anyone in my party, typically. That's always why whenever I see Virgus get nuked, I'm very alarmed. Because usually, whatever nuked Virgus is extremely evil. Because Virgus is usually extremely difficult to kill. Like, uncharacteristically difficult to kill. Most of the time, not all the time. But most of the time. I'm not going for sacred, there's no point. So how close are we? Sergeant. It's done. Stage 5 or higher of the Fire Knight's Castle. Yuck. Alright! So then there's that. Then I have to just fight a clan boss, which shouldn't be hard at all. 1.5 million is paltry. This is gonna be a pain in the rear. This is also going to be a pain in the rear, because who the hell am I going to... Yeah.